This guide gives a good alternative to ShareX for setting up audio recording on a Mac. So I just wanted to do a demonstration setup, and I'll try and stay as brief as possible. So go to this section here, and basically there are these two programs you need to install, and also a corresponding script for this program, which has also very kindly been provided. So go to the first link, and free download, and unzip the file. And the program is called Piezo, so move this to your applications folder. Then go across to Spotlight and start typing in Piezo. When it turns up, hit enter and open. And in this section, in this first section here, you just need to select whatever web browser it is that you use. And if you go to the cogwheel, which opens up the settings, you need to set up the audio quality. So the guide asks you to use music low quality, which is for internet distribution. Okay, so move back to the guide and go to the second link and free trial. And unzip the file. And this program is Keyboard Maestro, so move this to your applications. Then in Spotlight, start typing in keyboard, and when it comes up, hit enter. And open. And now for now, you don't really need this window, so close it. And if you go down to the Global Macro Group, they've already got these kind of demonstration macros set up, but you don't really need these, so you can select them and hit the minus button to get rid of them, to delete them. Okay, so come back to your guide and then go to download the script and hit download, but the file is quite small, so it shouldn't take long. And then take your file. So this is the script here, it's Piezo recording, and this is what the macro, KM macros. So double tap this to load it into your program. And this is what the program, this is what the script looks like. And so basically there are four things you need to do here. So firstly, you'll see these four key bindings here, they need to be changed. So the first one is Command I, then the second one is Command R, then Command R, and the last one, Command I. And next, you come to this section here and you have to put in your username. So if you go to type Command N to open up a Finder window, and you'll find your username is printed next to this little house icon here. So this is my username. So I'll type this in here. And the third thing you need to do is just make sure that this box is checked here. And finally, you need to activate the script. So you have to hit run here. And that activates the script. Okay, so now you are set up, you're ready to go. So we just need to check that it works by doing a kind of test run. So, firstly, this keyboard Maestro doesn't need to be open as it runs automatically in the background. So, firstly, you can close this window. But this Piezo does need to be open. So what I like to do is, I've already done it, but I like to move this Piezo and keep it in my dock next to my web browser, as I will be using these two together most of the time. Okay, so let's move over to our web browser, and we can just tidy things up a bit here. And I've got this video set up on YouTube. It's good to overlap the two programs here. You'll see why. Then I get my keyboard open so you can see the shortcut. So the pattern is to do, you type in the shortcut, which starts the audio recording. Then you play the video, and when the video finishes, you type the same shortcut to stop the audio recording. So it goes shortcut, play video, shortcut. Okay, so this is how you do it. And the shortcut is command tilde. So here we go.
You can't handle the truth!
Okay, so it was went a bit wrong there. Let's try it again.
You can't.
So one more time.
You can't handle the truth.
Okay, and then it will open up when the recording's finished. It will open up this window here, and where all your video recordings are kept. So if you just press spacebar.
You can't handle the truth!
That's the audio recording that it just did. And it's also, if you go to show your clipboard, I think you'll notice that it's pasted that recording. Maybe not. If we go to your notes, and then you hit command paste. Let's try that one more time. Okay.
You can't handle the truth.
Okay, there, it's made the bit the audio, and then you hit command paste. And hey presto, it's, and you can play it.
You can't handle the truth!
So there we go, that's it. It's a bit fiddly at first, that last bit, but you do it a few times and it starts working. Beautiful!